Welcome to vlog 15! Happy Easter! Welcome to vlog 15! It's Easter! So, how was your Easter? Mine was amazing. I love Easter, and it's not all about the chocolate. Well, it is all about the chocolate. I mean, I'm sure there's other stuff to it, but it's all about the chocolate. I had a lovely weekend at home with my parents in Cumbria, eating chocolate. Anyway, back to last week. I had a little day off on Monday, went up to Crewe, visited some friends, played with their children. They've got 11, 12, I don't know, they've got a lot of children. Especially my friend Hillary, she's got triplets. They're cute, but relentless. Speaking of children, they do say never work with children or animals. So on Tuesday, I went to see, I don't know if I can say it. Oh, sod it. Awkward conversations with animals I've... Yes. Oh, come on, it's PG. So this was on at the King's Head Theatre, which if you know, is a little theatre at the back of a pub. And when the show went up, the guy on the box office literally had to shout that title out to a pub full of people. He didn't seem to mind. Anyway, this is a play that had the most shocking title in Edinburgh Fringe 5 years ago. And Rob Hayes has brought it back to the King's Head. Originally starring Rob Holden, is now back with a new actor called Linus Karp. What is it? Well, exactly what the title says. A one-man show describing sexual encounters with animals. Yes, it's exactly that. Fucking awkward. I mean, it's just random. In a kind of good way? Do you know what it is? It felt like a 5 minute stand-up comic routine stretched out into an hour long play, and it kind of loses a bit of momentum and then cuts. Yeah, it's weird. Linus was perfectly cast. He is incredibly awkward. Bless him. Couldn't work out whether he had a lisp or a foreign accent. He possibly had both. Some of the humour is funny. Drawing parallels to actual first date, to how you would actually talk after a one night stand perhaps, about a person, and then cleverly uses innuendos and adapting them to fit animals. It's hard to explain. Also, the King's Head, I had forgotten how squished in they pack those seats and how hot it gets. Woo! It's on until the 27th of April in the 9:30 slot at the King's Head. Yeah. Check it out. On Wednesday, I went to see All My Sons at the Old Vic. Now, I have a bit of a love-hate relationship with the Old Vic. Some of the stuff I see there is incredible. A Monster Calls, A Christmas Carol. But then sometimes I just think they misshoot the mark. Like recently, American Clock did nothing for me. So with this new version of Arthur Miller's classic, I wasn't really sure what to expect, other than Sally Field was in it. I adore Sally Field. She reminds me of my mum, which I think's why I love her. So I knew nothing about the play other than it starred Sally Field, Bill Pullman and Jenna Coleman from Doctor who I love. And honestly, it is a stunning, beautiful, heart-wrenchingly devastating play. It's incredible. It's quite short as well, only an hour each act. And honestly, you're left... Oh, just go and see it. The chance to see a phenomenal actress like Sally Field in this environment is incredible. She's incredible. And yeah, everything about this, the stage and design is exquisite. I won't spoil it by telling you what happens, but I was honestly so moved. It's beautiful. I really hope it does well. The Old Vic is still having extensive work done on their toilets, so you still have to pee in a port-a-loo on the street. But don't let that put you off. So on Wednesday, I struggled to get a date. Can you believe it? Nobody wanted to come to the theatre with me. Fortunately, my friend Bran Regis stepped in, and she's beautiful. She's probably the most beautiful date I've ever had. After that, I ran across to the Arts Theatre for my friend Dolly's 50th birthday. We then ended up in the Phoenix Arts Club. Till late. On Thursday, I finally got to see the Rocky Horror Show. This show's been on tour all year, and I missed it when it was in Wimbledon, so I finally got to see it this week in Bromley. Teaming up again after being in Flashdance together, Ben Adams and Joanne Clifford. Unfortunately, Ben wasn't on that night. A little bit gutted. Not because I don't love an understudy, only because I do love Ben Adams. I was a massive A1 fan. So yeah, it was a bit of a shame that I didn't get to see him. But Jake Small, Art's Ed boy, who went on for Ben, was incredible. Fantastic. Honestly. So yeah, it was great to see him. And of course, I got to see Callum Evans in the flesh. Callum is looking incredible. And I'll be honest, he's probably one of the best Rockies I've ever seen in any of the shows I've seen. Obviously, it's a very physically demanding part. You have to look aesthetically beautiful, which Callum does. But he throws in his acrobatic tricks. He is an amazing acrobat. He's incredible. But also, like, you have to be able to sing and act. I mean, I know it's a bit of a bonkers show and it's not really a story, but his character is a newborn child, effectively, which Callum plays on really well. So yeah, good lad. And he's Welsh. Love a Welsh man. I love any man in tiger hot pants. Philip Franks, who if you're as old as me, will remember him from the Darling Buds of May, does an incredible job as a narrator. Now, Rocky Horror is a bit of a hard show to navigate. If you've been, you will know that the audience participation can often get a bit out of hand. At some points, it's quite funny when they heckle the narrator. Other points, it just gets a bit incessant and annoying. But you go with it. And like I say, Phil Franks did a brilliant job of using and playing on every heckle that you got. I mean, it is one of those shows where you do need to go with a group of people and get drunk to really appreciate it, and even dress up. Of course, I was there by myself, not dressed up, and not drunk. I missed out. Should have gone on Friday. Anyway, I had an incredible night, and Stephen Webb is brilliant, as are all the cast. Go and see it. It's continuing to tour around the country till November. Joanne Clifford from Strictly Come Dancing is great as well. Honestly, her voice is lovely. And if you get to see Ben Adams, let me know how he is. Tell him I love him. So this week, I interviewed 18 of the cast of Market Boy at the Union Theatre. This play by David Eldridge was originally done in 2006 at the National Theatre, and Sasha Reagan has brought in a cast of 21 people. Wow. If you know the Union Theatre, that is tight. I don't mean the budget. I'm seeing it this week, so I'll tell you all about it in my vlog next week. But in the meantime, here's a little clip from my interview, which you can see in full on my YouTube channel.
How much can we give away?
High energy, lots of 80s nostalgia, and a lot of laughs.
It's like a hit of energy.
The first 5 minutes are kind of a sensory overload.
A lot goes on, a lot goes on. It's a coming of age story. It's, you know, it's teenagers, it's that kind of feeling of only one thing matters in your life, and that's the person you fancy. Without giving too much.
On Monday, Ben Hewis took 100 young women to see Amelia. He had no problem finding a date. Only kidding. It was part of an incredible initiative. He raised enough money through crowdfunding to enable 100 people to see this incredible show. Well done, Ben, and I hope everybody who did see it enjoyed it. Also announced this week, Jonathan Harvey and the Pet Shop Boys have teamed up again to do a follow-up to their musical Closer to Heaven. The new musical will be called Music and will be going up to Edinburgh Fringe this summer. It tells the story of Billy Trix, originally played in Closer to Heaven 18 years ago by Frances Barbara, who will reprise the role in this one-woman show. It is going to be incredible. Frances Barbara is an amazing actress, and the music of Pet Shop Boys, again with Jonathan Harvey's incredibly witty script, is bound to be incredible. If you're going up to Edinburgh, make sure you check it out. Along with Paul Taylor Mills, who is taking up Cruel Intentions. I loved this 90s film with Sarah Michelle Gellar, so this I'm really excited about. Jack Maple, who produced The Rink at Suffolk Playhouse, announced this week the incredible lineup for his new show, The View Upstairs, which comes to the Soho Theatre on the 18th of July. The cast includes Declan Bennett, John Partridge, Cedric Neal, who you might have seen recently in The Voice, Victoria Hamilton Barrett, who is incredible, and Andy Miantis, who you might recognise from Smash. It's going to be directed by Jonathan Boyle, who's just finished the Hair Tour, and choreographed by Fabian Alois, who was announced last week as the choreographer of Evita. And his production of Madagascar is back again next year. He's gonna be a busy, busy boy. And probably quite a wealthy one. Just saying. In other casting news, the Barn Theatre in Cirencester, where I visited last week, have announced their cast for Henry V. It will include Aaron Sidwell and Lauren Samuels. I love them both. So I cannot wait to see this. That will open on the 22nd of May. So if you fancy a trip to Cirencester, get yourself there. I'm now coming to you live from Cumbria. That is my parents' back garden. I've been here for the weekend. I got lots of chocolate. Shall we carry on? Let's carry on. I went to see a workshop presentation of Gretel at the Other Palace. I really liked it. One of those shows where you're watching it and already you want to revisit it and watch it again before it's even finished. Now, this is a brand new musical with the book by Liv Ward and the music and lyrics by Charlie Turner. Liv Ward is a friend of mine who I did a writing course at the National with a couple of years ago. Earlier this year, she wrote the play Anomaly at the Old Red Lion. They put this together in about 5 to 6 months, and to say that, it is incredible. It's a really nice mix of classic and pop. The songs are catchy, the book is hilarious. Liv's got a real ear and observation for dialogue and how people really talk. And it really is funny. And given that I was there last week to watch James Bourne and Stephen Satel's production Murder at the Gate, which has been in development for 2 years, I would say that this felt more developed, just better. So Charlie started writing the music back in November and Liv came on board in about February, so they've not had long to develop it, but given that, it is in really, really good shape. As a working development, everybody in the cast was off book, and the production values were incredible, including the beautiful costume design. Liv also directed the piece brilliantly. This is the future of musical theatre, a young, fresh, female take on a classic work. It's genius. I'm really excited to see what else comes of this, so keep an eye out for it. Maybe we can rewrite our soul. You don't have to play that. Was in aid of Gallup, which is an LGBT plus anti-violence charity that support anybody who's been a victim of homophobic attacks. They do a lot of great work, so it's really generous of Charlie and Liv to support that charity and give all the proceeds to them. On Friday night, I also went to see Tuck Shop live at the Underbelly Festival. Tuck Shop is a new management team formed by producer Christopher Clegg. They produce shows like Gals Aloud, the Girls Aloud tribute band, and Drag in Soho. And if you're a fan of Kitty Scott Claus and Ophelia Love and Drag Race, you should check out their YouTube channel for their series, The Teabag, where each week they review episodes of Drag Race. Ophelia and Kitty were there on Friday night to perform songs from Six again.
Divorced. Beheaded. Survived.
I'm not Berlin girl and I'm up next. See, I broke England from the church. Yeah, I'm that sexy. Why did I lose my head? Well, my sleeves may be green, but my lipstick's red. Grew up in the French court. We were born yet. Life was a chore, so
she set sail.
1522 came straight to the UK. All the British dudes lame.
Epic fail.
Control, no matter how many times I knew you lied. Have my golden rule, gotta keep my cool, baby. And even though you've had your fun running around with some pretty young things, and even though you've had one song with someone who don't earn a wedding ring, no matter what I heard, I didn't say a word, oh, baby.
Also performing was Cheryl Hole, who is also a part of the Gals Aloud tribute band. And if you believe the rumours, she might be appearing in the UK version of Drag Race. Allegedly. Trailer that they made from Friday night, and if you want to know more, follow Tuck Shop UK on Twitter.
When you're voguing fem, just to get those sense, you're the creme de la creme, I want you to stop.
I want to see one way, I want to see old way, I want to see new way. I wanna see you slay.
Eating the runway, serving the runway, marching the runway, eat that runway.
Eating the runway, serving the runway, marching the runway, eat that runway.
Walk. Where my face kids at? Where my glam queens at? Where my real queens at? You want it? Take it to the back.
On the runway, where we don't play. I want it my way. Don't be shady. Be a lady. Go crazy.
Look at me, look at me, look at me, bitch. Look at me, look at me, look at me, bitch. M to the I to the motherfucking Z.
The elements, elements, the elements, elements, the elements, elements, all five elements.
Look at me, look at me, look at me, bitch. Look at me, look at me.
me, look at me, bitch. M to the I to the motherfucking Z. You can't help but look at me.
Five. Four, three, two, one. Category closed.
I turned it, right?
And also look out for Rosie Beaver's show on Thursday the 9th of May. It's going to be a riot. On Saturday, I travelled up to see West Side Story at the Royal Exchange Theatre in Manchester. It is a beautiful theatre. If you've ever been, it's presented in the round, completely open to the external light. So it gives this kind of extra feel when you're watching it. Andy Coxon and Gabriella Garcia play Tony and Maria in this classic retake of West Side Story. And it is a classic. It's a brilliant show, and I'd forgotten how brilliant. And they've done a really superb job with it. They haven't tried to meddle or mix it up too much. They've presented it in a really classic, stripped back way, which makes you just fall in love with the music and the characters all over again. And it is a heartbreaking story when you watch it. Andy Coxon is incredible. He is a bona fide leading man. If you saw him in Hair or Yank, you will know how great an actor he is. But his voice is sublime. And Gabriella Garcia is exquisite as Maria. It practically sold out before it even opened, so if you didn't get a chance to see it, they've just announced that they are going to be returning next year for another run. And hopefully Andy and Gabriella will come back. So that's it for this week. I'm going to go and eat some more Easter eggs. I think my parents are making a barbecue. Hope you've had a lovely weekend, and I'll see you next week when I'm back in London.